Pomona folks. Jack, morning Tony, morning Rob. Folks are joining us this morning. I'd love you to tell me where you're watching from. It's been great to be part of this kind of little family emerging over these last few weeks, and it'd be lovely to get to know you a little bit better. Tell us where you're watching from. Maybe tell us where in the UK, indeed further afield, where you're watching from as well. Give us a little bit more detail than that. Maybe tell us I'm watching from the lounge. I'm watching from the kitchen. I'm watching from the garden. I'd love to know where you're watching from. From Bristol. Avril, great to see you there in Bristol. Excellent. Folks, tell us where you're watching from this morning. I'd love to get to know you, this family, a little bit more. Morning, Eleanor. Morning, Mandy in Leicestershire. Excellent. Joy is in bed. Wonderful. I hope that's a good thing. Maybe it's a good thing to be in bed. Be relaxing as well. Morning from the Wirral over there. Excellent. Yeah, tell us where you're watching from this morning. Maybe tell us, yeah, what you've been up to this last week, what things you've been doing that have been an encouragement to you. It's been great, actually, this week, hasn't it? What a treat on Tuesday morning to hear Lou Fellingham lead us in that session. You know, I've grown up watching Lou Fellingham lead at different conferences and things, and it's always just a great, what a wonderful gift she is to the church and the whole Fellinghams family in their writing, in their leading, and just wonderful ministry time on Tuesday morning as well. Great to see you guys. Yeah, I've just been asking folks where they're watching from. Good morning, Phil from France. That's wonderful. Great to see that we're more than the UK. We're watching from around the world, indeed. From Norfolk. Excellent. Morning, Chris from your kitchen in Gateshead. Whilst eating your breakfast. Tell us what you're having for breakfast this morning, Chris. Love to know that. That'd be great. Excellent. Have I got the radio on in the background? I don't think I do. No. Can you hear a bit of background noise? Morning, folks. How are we getting on? Oh, we've got a Scottish flag up there this morning. Morning from the playroom. In the attempt to keep that, that's my wife, Jill. So you didn't hear them on the live stream. If there is a background radio noise, it may be our small people in our house running around a little bit. Morning, folks. It's great to have you joining us today. We're going to be singing a few songs today. We're going to sing that song that Ollie's been teaching us this last couple of weeks. Interesting that there's some background noise going on. Hello. You coming in to say hello? This is Jonah. This is the youngest of the tribe. This is my wife, Jill.
Hello. I'm also watching on the live stream. We can hear someone like singing, like opera singing.
Opera singing?
Yeah.
Can other people hear opera singing in the background?
So I've just literally come in just to see if there's a lady hiding in our house opera singing.
There was a car alarm a minute ago. That was a bit of background noise.
Is there any way there could be anything else feeding through?
Don't think so. Don't think so.
It's very beautiful.
There is a woman singing in the background. How strange. I am trying a slightly different setup this morning. I've plugged in a microphone. I can unplug that to see if that
changes.
See if that changes.
Are you
going
to wave and say hello, Elijah? Look. Say hello. My name's Elijah.
Elijah's 4. And he was a bit shy to come on the last time, but it's great to have you come and say hello.
Doing there?
Brilliant. You can hear opera singing?
Yeah, I'll maybe unplug the microphone.
Okay, let's unplug this. Let's go back to our basic setup.
We'll say goodbye. Hopefully the opera singer, we'll start. She's beautiful. And we'll stop. Let's see if that's worked.
Tell us if the opera singing has stopped this morning. I do like a bit of opera. Okay, give us a heads up if you think the music has stopped. I've changed onto our normal microphone. Don't have any Spotify on. That's a good tip. Good tip, though. Has it stopped now? Thank you, Hannah. That's wonderful. I was trying to plug in a microphone to bring you a little bit closer. My voice is quite quiet, actually, and our piano is quite loud. It emerged last week. So we thought we'd just try a slightly different setup, which clearly hasn't worked. It's on a different tune now. Has it stopped now? Has it definitely stopped? The background music. Thank you. That's good to know. Excellent. Well, we're gonna spend some time praising God together. I hope you've got the lyrics. If someone could copy the lyrics into the chat on this, that would be helpful. Otherwise, it's on our Cornerstone worship page there as well. If you're joining us for these sessions on a Thursday, it'd be great if you want to follow us on our Cornerstone Worship UK page, then you'll see the links and stuff automatically pop up there. Ollie is very kindly sharing the details to that as well on his page, and that'd be great. Let me commit our time to the Lord in prayer. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you so much for each and every day, and your grace and your goodness to us in each breath we take, in everything we do. Lord, we pray that this day we would be those who are able to see your presence and your power at work in our lives. What a gift it is to follow you. What a privilege it is to follow you each and every day. Lord, we pray that you would take this day and use it for your glory. Amen. Well, let's join together by singing that great hymn, I Stand Amazed. In the save us, to rescue us, to bring us home to glory. And we'll see you face to face. What a marvelous sight, what a wonderful day. We're singing, how marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. Oh, how marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. Thank you. that day. We look forward to that day when the Lord Jesus, you will come and you'll bring us to our heavenly home. There'll be restoration. There'll be new joy, new life. The world as it should be. All longing will be satisfied. All tears will be a distant memory. Oh Lord, we long for that day. Help us rejoice as we wait. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We're going to turn in a moment to a little passage in Acts 16. But before we do that, I'd just love to ask you a question just to see if there's any responses to that. And the question is this. What do you think during lockdown you have been able to spend a little bit more time doing? What maybe that you would normally do in a rush or a hurry that you would be able to spend a little bit more time enjoying doing that? One thing for me has been coffee. I do like coffee. I wouldn't say I'm a coffee snob. I enjoy good quality coffee and well made and well prepared and all that. But you know, sometimes for me in a rush, you know, a nice instant coffee would do. But during lockdown, it's been, you know, getting the froth right, getting all of that done, and enjoy just spending a little bit more time making coffee. What have you been spending a little bit more time doing than you would normally do in a bit of a rush? Cycling, gardening, from Janet there. That's great. You know, it's great to see our garden, I must admit, was a bit of a bare patch before we started lockdown, and it's just been great to be, you know, growing some seeds and seeing that emerge. Somebody said reading God's word, that's been wonderful to see. More time to be able to enjoy that. Cleaning my house, has that been a joy to you? hope it has been. Knitting, that's wonderful. We've got some friends who are knitting little jumpers and sending them to the other side of the world, and that's just great. Meals with family, yeah, that's such a true one. You know, we've definitely enjoyed that. Meals at the table as a family, somebody else said, you know, sometimes we'll be in a bit of a rush or people will be rushing in and out. And Caleb, you've said spending more time with my family, that's lovely. Cooking, enjoying those things. Somebody else echoing the coffee, that's great. From the bean to cup, it's the only way for some people, absolutely. Sewing and walking, that's it. One thing that we've enjoyed as well as a family is something called geocaching. Some of you, I'm sure, will know what geocaching is. There's a little app, and you can go for a walk, and you can find little boxes with messages in them and treasure. There's millions of them around the world. If you've not heard of geocaching and you've got kids of really of any age, or actually of any age, then you would really enjoy that. Playing the piano, chatting to my eldest about life through his eyes. That's great. Lovely to spend some more time. And that's, you know, it's great for us, isn't it, in the midst of what we're going through, what's going on in the world, to pause and reflect on what have been some of the joys to us, what have been the things that we've been able to pause and enjoy more time doing that. Linda says making telephone calls to her friends. Oh, we know, Linda, that's been really appreciated by our church family. Thank you so much for doing that. There's been a real ministry, I think, in one anothering, which we've seen, definitely people picking up the phone and spending a bit more time than maybe they would normally be able to, encouraging some other people in the church family. You know, we try to do that a little bit. On a Sunday, we watch our online service and then just spending maybe half an hour, pick up the phone, and as you would normally chat to people after the church service, just spending a bit of time encouraging people in that way. That's been wonderful. Oh, lots of creative ideas. I'm going to look back at this thread later on and see some more ideas of things that I should pause and spend a little bit more time doing at this time as well. Let's grab our Bibles and turn to Acts 16. The second bin lorry of the day has arrived. Thankful for that. The gardening waste is gone, so we can crack on and do a bit more later on. Acts chapter 16. We're going to look at that. I'm not going to read the whole chapter. But the question for me as we kind of get into this was, one of the things that I have enjoyed doing a little bit more of during this time is things like this. You know, at the start of the day, spending some time singing together with people from actually across Europe, across the world really, who might be tuning into this, or other things that have been an encouragement for singing. And one of my favorite examples of singing in the Bible comes from Acts chapter 16. And the verse 25, if you zoom in on that, just to begin with, I want to bring us into the narrative of this passage. But verse 25 on its own paints a picture, but when you see it in the light of the rest of the passage, which might be familiar to us, it tells us something more, something deeper, I think. Verse 25 says, about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Interesting, isn't it? That they were praying and singing hymns, and yet there were those listening, people outside, people like a fly on the wall, an ear on the wall, listening to what was going on. You know, I really like the idea that maybe across Nottingham, where we live, across the cities and the places where you are, that people have the potential to walk down the street and hear people worshiping God in their homes. That's a really wonderful potential, isn't it? You know, maybe the windows are open, maybe the doors are open, maybe we're in our garden when we're watching church, when we're watching the Come and Sing with Me's in the morning, that people could be listening in, could be tuning in to what was going on. Well, the context for Paul and Silas, we'll see, is not a kind of relaxing place to be able to join and sing, but they are indeed in prison. And let me read just a little bit of the section before. They are confronted with this young woman who is a fortune teller. She's a slave and she's got an evil spirit, and she comes and she's kind of harassing Paul and shouting at them as they are doing this missionary work. And it says this in verse 19. When her owners realized that their hope of making money was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace to face the authorities. They brought them before the magistrates and said, "These men are Jews and are throwing our city into an uproar by advocating customs unlawful for us Romans to accept or practice." The crowds joined in the attack against Paul and Silas, and the magistrates ordered them to be stripped and beaten with rods. After they had been severely flogged, they were thrown into prison, and the jailer was commanded to guard them carefully. When they received these orders, he put them in the inner cell and fastened their feet in the stocks. And then they sang. And then they sang. That's a powerful image, really, isn't it? Paul and Silas, they're stripped and beaten with rods. They've been flogged. They've been put in the stocks, fastened securely in those stocks, punished in prison, and they sing. In the middle of their suffering, they're singing. You know, I think one of the pictures for me there is there's nothing slick about their singing. It's not that they're singing, you know, beautifully with, you know, maybe like we might enjoy if we're involved in music ministry in our churches. It's not that they're you know, got their in-ears in and they've got beautiful accompaniments and instruments and, you know, they've got a congregation singing along with them. You know, there's no auto-tune or nothing's been polished or compressed or anything like that. What they've got is raw singing, raw worship and praise to their gods. There's nothing slick about their worship. Maybe you look at your church and you think there's nothing slick about our worship. You know, I look at what we're doing this morning, there's nothing slick about our setup. We've got a phone and a piano. There's nothing slick about this at all. And yet, here we see in this passage that there is still the potential to see the power of singing. Singing has a power. Read on with me from verse 26. They're singing to God. The other prisoners are listening to them. Suddenly there was a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once all the prison doors flew open and everyone's chains came loose. The jailer woke up, and when he saw the prisoner's doors open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself because he thought the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted, "Don't harm yourself. We're all here." The jailer called for lights, rushed in and fell trembling before Paul and Silas. He then brought them out and asked, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household." Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all the others in his house. At that hour of the night, the jailer took them and washed their wounds. Then immediately he and all his household were baptized. The jailer brought them into his house and set a meal before them. He was filled with joy because he had come to believe in God, him and his whole household. There's power, power in our singing. And, you know, I think one of the questions for me when I was thinking about this, and, you know, the fact that people might be listening in, is, are we singing with the windows open? Are we singing with the windows open? Not just kind of physically in our house, so that might be a challenge for us to think about being a little bit more public about our faith so that people might notice what we're doing. But are we sharing the fact that we are still able to meet as church? And the church is not closed. And I think that message has been heard again and again during this time. The church has not closed. There is still the opportunity to sing and to make music. Paul and Silas are singing, and there's power in that. This jailer hears what they're doing and is just so in awe of the fact that they have not escaped prison, of what God has done. The prison, the earthquake which has come, the prison doors have flown open, and yet they've not escaped. They stay. The jailer responds by saying, "What must I do to be saved?" You know, that's that wonderful image, isn't it? My chains fell off, my heart was free, I rose, went forth, and followed thee. You know, that is a metaphor of what's happening in the life of the believer there when we are saved. And he asked, "What must he do to be saved?" He says, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your whole household." And there's verse 33, there's this beautiful image, just to draw you into that, which says, "At that hour of the night, the jailer took them and washed their wounds. They immediately, him and all his household, were baptized." You know, as the unbeliever comes to faith, he washes the wounds of the prisoners, as he then is washed from his sins. That's just a lovely image there, isn't it? You know, as and baptism is that illustration of the cleansing, the washing, the death to life image of the believer. As the prisoner comes, as the prison, the jailer comes and washes out the wounds of the prisoners, so he is washed from his sins. That is a hugely powerful image, I think, there. Paul and Silas sing in their suffering. And I read this week, which was helpful, I think, on this passage. They sang because when the people of God proclaim his name in song, regardless of our circumstances, it is powerful. God's glory fills our environment. Our faith is strengthened. The church is built up. Even when you're alone and your church family is hundreds of miles away from a cramped jail cell in the middle of Greece, even when you are stuck at home watching church in your pajamas, you're distracted by your children, even when you're in your room with your headphones plugged into your laptop, your non-Christian housemates maybe are right outside your door, able to listen in. Even, especially when you're in the midst of isolation, pain, confusion, burned out, the church needs to keep singing together. What are you missing most about church? I asked that question, I think, last week. I'm really missing hearing my church family singing together. There's power in our singing. It's an encouragement even now, you know, to know that there are hundreds of people around the UK joining in with our songs in this time. What a joy it is to partner together with people as we know the power of singing, the power of the Lord Jesus and all that he has done for us. We're going to sing of that power, the power of the cross, the power of salvation for us, that we could have life through the Lord Jesus, his death and resurrection. Cry. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Ollie yesterday launched a Kickstarter project to raise some money to support his friends who will be helping him make this album, this LP, with some wonderful songs which are emerging on it. And praise God, wasn't it great to see how encouraging the response to that Kickstarter project was yesterday? I think £4,500 was the initial goal which was set, which was absolutely smashed yesterday, which is brilliant. One of the opportunities that Ollie has is to make some physical CDs, and I think there's a new target now of about £6,000, and actually even more if there'll be more possible, more able to be done if more money is raised. So do get behind that and support that. It feels a bit awkward actually promoting yourself and saying come and support us and raise money, but do get behind Ollie's project and absolutely smash it through the roof. It'd be great to see that fully supported. Somebody could post a link to the Kickstarter project. That would be brilliant to be able to do that now. Support Ollie, get behind him and the guys who are doing that. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, and it'd be great if you could follow us on Facebook, like our page, so that next week you're able to get onto this link. I know some people have found it difficult to find us on a Thursday, but if you like and follow us on Facebook, then you'll find that a little bit easier. Great to be joined by my family just now to say hello. I've just knocked over some water. You know, there's nothing slick about what we're doing here on a Thursday. It's been great for you to join us. God bless. Take care, guys. Have a good day.